This is the SGI MooseCam, released in 1996 alongside with the Silicon Graphics O2 workstation. Long had I searched for it, and the moment I found it, it turned out it doesn't connect with the stock O2 but needs this special AV board. Said that, the AV board has both composite and S-video in and out connectors, so I set out to see if I can get it working for VHS video capturing and recording. Obsolete computer technology is my passion. I'm the vintage collector, and these are my stories. So this is the O2 cam, also sometimes referred to as the Moose cam or Moose head camera, which is a nod at the Moose head project under which the O2 was originally developed. This cam comes in the classic Silicon Graphics granite look, although it was also available in the more modern dark grey enclosure. The O2 cam features this button here, which can start an instant recording into SGI's media recorder, and also this wheel here for focusing the lens. Plus it has a front accessible manual shutter, an activity LED, and a built-in microphone. Using the tilt hinge, you could place it onto the frame of a CRT display. Thinking of my 1600 SW flat panel display, that's definitely going to be interesting. The SGI presenter accessory also featured a receptacle to hold the Moose cam.
And even so, SGI never made any laptops. Some laptop lookalikes sporting the SGI presenter were prominently featured in the 1996 movie Twister.
Don't get me into ideas. As noted in the O2 user's guide, the O2 cam was not a standard accessory to all O2 workstations. In fact, the O2 base model had only this audio board equipped, which didn't feature any video connectors. So you definitely need the so-called audio-visual module, which features additional S-video and composite input and output connectors, and an additional socket on the backside to connect the O2 cam. Swapping out the original audio module is as easy as flipping the lever and pulling it out, then sliding in the new audiovisual module. As a word of caution, do that only with the O2 fully powered off and disconnected from the mains. Do not leave the power cable plugged, as the system board still carries a voltage, even if the system is powered down. With the new AV module inserted, you then simply connect the O2 cam. It will show up automatically in the system inventory that you can call up both in the PROM monitor but also on the running system using the HINV command. And so it also shows up automatically on the IRIX desktop from which you drop directly into media recorder and double clicking the camera icon.
What's this blur?
Right, let's unblur it by adjusting the focus. But quality is naturally not as good as any present day webcam. The O2 cam records in NTSC 512x480 format for a total of roughly 0.23 megapixels. It was mainly intended for video conferencing and SGI's video mail, but that's a story for another day. For today, I rather want to focus a bit further on the AV board and SGI's video recording and editing capabilities. Actually, I had explored this to some extent already before. And while I was working on this SGI 230 workstation, which, as opposed to the MIPS-based O2, is an Intel-based machine, I once retrofitted this Canopus DV Raptor into it to do some capturing. We'll see that eventually in a follow-up episode. As for the O2, I'm about to connect this VCR to it. Unfortunately, it doesn't have many connection options. While I do have loads of cables, I will need to specifically use SCART adapters like these in order to wire up some RCA cables to the O2. Now, using media recorder, which is currently capturing from the O2 cam, one can easily switch over to the analog input, be that either the S-video or composite. As I started using composite input, let's see if we'll actually get a feed. Aha, look at who had taped an episode of good old Star Trek ages ago. Using the video input panel, you can adjust the capture settings to improve the results.
Außerdem kinderleichter Einbruch. Die Kinder jedes Türschloss knacken und damit Deutschlands Sicherheitsexperten vorführen.
And even though the footage was captured in standard definition, it's no surprise it takes ages to save the video file. As noted before, the AV board also features S-video connectors. So I used this special SCART adapter, which also features an S-video socket, and connected it accordingly. And here's the two captures side by side, S-video to the left and composite to the right. So it's possible to capture from a VCR, but it should also be possible to export the video via the analog output. I've shown you some glimpses of Adobe Premiere for SGI IRIX on an earlier occasion already. This time round, I wanted to simply take my captured video and export it to the VCR. Premiere calls this print to video. Now, while it did seem to do something, it always aborted the video just after 1 second, making it impossible to record it from the VCR. Maybe that version of Premiere required a specific VCR with some sort of remote control. But IRIX itself came with its own video editor, Movie Maker, which has nothing to do with its sibling by name, Windows Movie Maker. It too has an option print to video, but is more specific on the user instructions. But even though I tried several times, I never seemed to get my video recorded on the VCR. Of course, I moved the RCA cables to the output and also had flipped the signal direction switch on the adapter. But when checking back at the video cassette, I always ended up seeing white snow. In order to exclude any issues with the output signal, I attached this small TV screen. But it quickly proved that I was actually getting an output signal. At least it helped me to realize that my VCR was taping from channel 1, which of course doesn't make any sense. It should be recording from the auxiliary. And this way, I could actually record back from my O2 onto the VCR and then even feed it back in again. Of course, video quality was suffering a lot, as I didn't use the best cable connections and also my VCR wasn't a professional apparatus either. But the O2 once was, and this demo is yet another perfect showcase of SGI's multimedia capabilities of the mid-90s. What do you think about it? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching and see you again next Sunday.